name is Azizjon Azimi. I'm the chairman of the board of TajRupt, and I've had the privilege of leading the digital cohort of Innovation Incubator over the past couple of months. So we are going to be presenting today the final product of our project, which focuses on artificial intelligence and pioneering AI in Tajikistan's economy over the coming years, looking into the future. So in the beginning, I want to present the presenters themselves, and with much joy and happiness, let me first introduce Maqsudjon Khalandarov from Khujand State University. Round of applause, please. Next, we have Khosiyat, Oripova from Polytechnic Lyceum in Khujand. We have Abbosjon, Madiev from school number 5 of Jabbor, Rasulov district. We have Dildora, Hikmatulloeva from the Lyceum for Gifted Students in Khujand. And we have our one and only course assistant, Avazkhon, Sidykov, Gymnasium number 4 in Khujand. Okay, so you guys can follow the presentation on the TV screen, and we'll also give you guys copies of the presentation slides. In the beginning, let me just give a brief introduction. This is the first actual slide of the presentation about the Innovation Incubator Cohort 2, which has been taking place since February of 2018. So we've been going on for 3 months now. The topics that we've covered have ranged from supply and demand analysis to consumer and producer theory, to comparative advantage in international trade, startup entrepreneurship and capital markets, and finally digitalization and artificial intelligence. So you can see, for example, in the upper left column there, Maqsudjon, Dildora, and Azizjon there as well, connecting over Skype, because I was Skyping in from the Kennedy School at Harvard once a week over the past 3 months, and we've been conducting digital courses. So we used to have Sunday morning lectures your time, which corresponded to Saturday evening for me. We also had a lot of case discussions, so we put emphasis on giving information to students about real cases that took place, cases from Nike to Facebook, and even global coffee trade, and we had students debate and discuss their viewpoints on how they would act as managers and executives of those companies. What we did at the end after covering these 6 topics was we debated and discussed which topic we should conduct a project on, and the way we went about measuring that was which concept will have the most impact and can benefit Tajikistan's economy the most in the coming decades. And what we selected at the end was artificial intelligence, not just because AI is all over the news, everyone's talking about AI, automation, machine learning, but also because Tajikistan's economic model today is dependent on 2 volatile factors. It's export of raw materials, as Maqsudjon will cover, and dependence on migrant remittances that you will see in the presentation. And both of those factors are incredibly volatile if you consider changing global commodity prices or our dependence on Russia, which has had an economic crisis for the past couple of years. So it's always not good for an economy to be dependent on external factors and to such a degree as Tajikistan's economy. That's why we thought AI, artificial intelligence, because it's such a new field that is still developing as a field from a research perspective and from a business perspective as well, has a huge potential to give Tajikistan the competitive advantage in the economy of the future. The structure for today will be as follows. Dildora will give an introduction into what artificial intelligence is and what it entails. Then we'll have Maqsudjon provide an overview of the economy of Tajikistan. What is the GDP like? What are the services sector, industry, agriculture, and other sectors in total? What is the share of the GDP, exports, and our per capita income? Then we're going to go to Abbosjon, who's going to speak about the impact of AI in the future on agriculture and industry in Tajikistan. And then we'll have Khosiyat pick up and speak about how AI can be introduced as an industry in Tajikistan itself in the future and bring us competitive advantage. And then we'll have also a little bit of Khosiyat talking about the services sector as well. Finally, we'll have Avazkhon giving a conclusion and some key takeaways of the presentation. So without much further ado, I'm going to pass it on to our first presenter. Let's give some warm round of applause to Dildora to talk about what is artificial intelligence.
First and foremost, thank you for having me that comes to your mind. Some people perceive AI as an army of robots that will take over humankind in the future, while others look to AI as a future of progress and efficiency. Let me briefly discuss what artificial intelligence is and how it works. The term artificial intelligence was coined by the Stanford researcher John McCarthy in 1955. McCarthy defined intelligence as the ability to achieve goals in the world. As a process, intelligence involves critical thinking and problem solving, and is mostly applicable to humans. Fundamentally, artificial intelligence is the ability of a machine or of the computer program to perform, to think and learn like humans do. So, according to research from McKinsey, investors globally invest 26 and $39 billion in 2016 alone. So due to its vast impact across sectors of the economy, AI is well positioned to revolutionize different industries. Today, machines are already engaged in a variety of tasks. Let's take an example of Google Assistant. We will listen to a CEO of Google, Sundar Pichai.
Turns out, a big part of getting things done is making a phone call. You may want to get an oil change schedule, maybe call a plumber in the middle of the week, or even schedule a haircut appointment. You know, we are working hard to help users through those moments. We want to connect users to businesses in a good way. Businesses actually rely a lot on this, but even in the US, 60% of small businesses don't have an online booking system set up. We think AI can help with this problem. So let's go back to this example. Let's say you want to ask Google to make you a haircut appointment on Tuesday between 10 and noon. What happens is the Google Assistant makes the call seamlessly in the background for you. So what you're going to hear is the Google Assistant actually calling a real salon to schedule the appointment for you. Let's listen.
Hi, I'm calling to book a woman's haircut for a client. I'm looking for something on May 3rd.
Sure, give me 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
Sure, what time are you looking for around?
At 12 p.m.
We do not have a 12 p.m. available. The closest we have to that is a 1:15.
Do you have anything between 10 a.m. and 12 p.m.?
Depending on what service she would like, what service is she looking for?
Just a woman's haircut for now.
Okay, we have a 10 o'clock.
10 a.m. is fine.
Okay, what's her first name?
The first name is Lisa.
Okay, perfect. So I will see Lisa at 10 o'clock on May 3rd.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Great. Have a great day. Bye.
So as Pichai notes, AI can bring real value added to consumers, but it can even large value added to businesses by increasing efficiency and productivity. Now let's hear from Maqsudjon, who will provide an overview of Tajikistan's economy. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dildora. Hello, everyone. Right now, I would like to talk about Tajikistan's economy. Tajikistan's economy has rapidly expanded since the civil war of the 1990s. The country's gross domestic product has gone from the lowest point of the $860 million in 2000 to the peak of over $9.2 billion in 2014, an increase of over 10 times. However, in the recent years, Tajikistan's GDP has contracted due to economic crisis in Russia, which has demonstrated our economy or dependence on migration. In 2016, the GDP decreased to slightly less than $7 billion. Concurrently, Tajikistan has the lowest GDP per capita among the post-Soviet countries. Today, our country is classified as a low middle income state by the World Bank. It is estimated that over 1 million citizens of Tajikistan are employed abroad, with nearly 90% of those abroad are working in Russia. In 2013, the World Bank estimates show that the remittances of Tajikistani migrants from abroad constituted 48% of the country's GDP. Total migrant remittances decreased from $3.7 billion in 2013 to $1.9 billion in 2016. However, given the recovery of Russia's economy, the inflow remittances of the Tajikistani rebounded to $2.6 billion in 2017. This graph shows the correlation of the migrant remittances and GDP of Tajikistan. While correlation is not causation, it is safe to say that migrant remittances and GDP of Tajikistan tend to move in similar direction. Now, I would like to talk about Tajikistan's main export. We have trade deficit of over $2 billion, meaning that we import much more than we export. Our biggest export are precious metals, aluminum, oil, gold, as well as raw cotton. This showcases that our exports are oriented toward raw materials, which makes the economy prone to price fluctuation of the global commodities.
As an example, this graph shows a consistent volatility that has marked to the price of aluminum in the past decades, which has added instability to producers in Tajikistan. At last, I would like to discuss a different sector of our economy. Nearly half of our GDP comes from the services sector that includes retail, finance, education, health, utility, and others. Agriculture forms less than a certain part of the GDP and includes farming, forestry, and fishing. Finally, industry makes up a quarter of the GDP and includes manufacturing, energy production, construction, and mining. In total, artificial intelligence can have a large impact in Tajikistan's economy, especially in the farming and services. Most importantly, it can pioneer an innovation economy to overcome Tajikistan's economic dependence on fluctuating factors such as the migrant remittances and the price of the raw materials that are unsustainable in the long term. Thank you. Right now, Abbosjon and Khosiyat are going to tell you about the impact of the artificial intelligence. Thank you.
Thank you, Maqsudjon. So now, in this section, Khosiyat and I will discuss the impact of AI on Tajikistan's economy. Following up on the framework set by Maqsudjon, our analysis will follow a sector-by-sector approach. Okay, let's discuss agriculture, because consistent growth in global population along with climate change have exerted a pressure on agricultural producers to meet the rising demand for food with an increase in supply. So, Tajikistan, having a fertility rate of 3.5 births per woman, which is very high by global standards, is also expected to face such pressure. So that is why AI can be of great benefit to Tajikistan's economy, especially to agricultural sector. So AI can produce improvements in productivity and operational efficiency in agriculture through three mechanisms. The first one is by using automation, such as self-driving tractors. And the next one is by technological product innovation. As an example, we can say bioengineering of seeds. And lastly, the third one is by data analytics through target farming and yield analysis. In addition, AI can bring significant value added by providing access to local farmers to online platforms. For example, marketplaces where buyers and sellers can make transactions directly, which would improve the supply chain efficiency by reducing the need for intermediaries. As an example, let's take cultivation of onion in Jabbor district, which is where I attend school. The current supply chain discriminates against farmers because these farmers sell their onion harvest to intermediaries who then go on to accrue much of the benefit by reselling most domestically and abroad. Because these farmers don't have access to online platforms, they're left with a small portion of the value of products that they actually collect. So, that's specialized in digital marketplaces, such as Alibaba in China or Amazon in the United States, would bring them significant value added by providing access to them to improve their farming productivity. A startup firm based in Princeton called Arab Labs has created a solar-powered in-ground sensor that gathers analytic data through deep learning algorithms. The technology improves precision farming and yield analysis and empowers farmers to better predict crop yields. Typically, as an example, which is very, very relevant for agricultural regions of Tajikistan that experience droughts and fluctuation in weather. At last, it is also important to mention AI in cotton production, which, as Maqsudjon said, is one of Tajikistan's biggest exports. So the AI technology called CN Spray, developed by American company Blue River Technology, allows monitoring and spraying feeds on cotton plants. As a major exporter of cotton, Tajikistan can benefit from the use of such technology by reducing the need for manual labor and increasing the productivity. So, at last, I think we need to move to discuss the impact of AI in industry and manufacturing. Maqsudjon noted that Tajikistan's primary export is raw materials as opposed to manufacturing goods. As such, the impact of AI is much bigger in the manufacturing sector as it can eliminate the job through AI, through automation. This has been the case in developed countries, such as the United States, where over 70% of manufacturing job losses since 2000 has come from automation, providing political pressures and change. Tajikistan doesn't face this kind of risk simply because our industrial base is very limited and mostly focuses on constructions. So, therefore, in the sphere of raw materials production, AI cannot bring a large impact on Tajikistan. So now, Khosiyat will discuss how we can broaden our industrial capacity through AI. Thank you for listening to me.
Thank you, Abbosjon. And now I would like to talk about pioneering artificial intelligence on industrial scale in our country and how it can benefit the entire economy of Tajikistan. The global AI market is expected to grow from the current size of a few billion dollars to nearly $60 billion by the end of 2025, a compounded annual growth of which is 50%. While advanced economies are leading the way in research and the use of AI, the global field is still wide open, and Tajikistan can gain a competitive advantage by using and focusing on AI. Public-private partnerships can enable opening of research and data centers that will position our country as the center of AI in our region. If so, Tajikistan could leverage the strong engineering background of our students, especially in rural areas, to attract foreign investors among companies like Google and Facebook that have been opening their AI labs all over the world, starting from Canada to China. Therefore, when we address industrialization, we shouldn't necessarily be talking about opening factories and plants. We should instead be focusing on AI and robotic centers that will make science and innovation Tajikistan main exports, not raw materials and immigration. Finally, a few words about the service sectors. The impact of AI will be tremendous in customer service segment applicable across retail, finance, and toys, as Google Assistant video demonstrated. Chatbots processing restaurant reservations, rubber readers grading students' essay, and mobile check deposit to your bank account, all are the present realities of AI that are yet to be implemented in Tajikistan. As such, applying AI in service sector will only follow industrial development of the segment. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Now I'd like to make a conclusion. Now, I'd like to summarize our presentation with a few key takeaways. First, we wanted to highlight that Tajikistan's current economic structure that is dependent on raw materials export and migrant remittances is unsustainable. We ought to focus on pioneering new technologies in order to gain competitive advantage in the economy of the future. Artificial intelligence, with its vast potential of impact across agriculture, industry, and services, presents Tajikistan an unparalleled opportunity to leap forward. By promoting AI, we will not only advance our education sector, we will also have much needed free and direct investment into the country. Our current economic position is comparable to the economic position of Singapore in the 1960s. Low GDP per capita, no significant natural resources, and inefficient bureaucracy. But the ability of Singapore to attract free and capital transformed it into one of the largest financial centers at a time when Western investors were investing into Asia. Tajikistan can have a similar path of development if we pioneer artificial intelligence and technology in Central Asia. Thank you, Eric McKay.
Most of them are from rural areas, and for them, having the technical know-how, the engineering background, AI is something that presents the future expertise and potential for them. So thank you all very much. We'll be here to mingle. Thank you.
There's the remittance issue and the fact that there are so many external factors that impact the economy. I mean, I think it's just excellent that you're thinking in these directions. And,
thank you. Quite interesting.
Yeah. How would you see AI developing in Tajikistan?
If you're going to focus on like farming and services, mm-hmm. it can impact a lot. Because as I already told, most importantly, it can pioneer innovation economy to overcome like economic dependence, Tajikistan's economic dependence on fluctuating factors. Mm-hmm. Like, as I already told, like migrant remittances, mm-hmm. like as I already told, like constituted 48% like of our GDP. This mm-hmm. is very like too long. Yeah. That's why
it's one of the highest in the world.
Yeah, highest in the world.
Facebook and Google are searching all places in order to build their data centers because of this information that comes to their data centers, it's getting really hot, and they need some cold places, so we have it on mountains, right?
We just thought and analyzed that Badakhshan is the one like coolest like place in Tajikistan. If you're gonna like make a data centers in there, it would be cool. Like,
I think it's great. I mean, there are certain competitive advantages.
Yeah, competitive advantages.
Evan, the countries from Central Asia, especially general from Asia, can come and learn what we have done here. For example, they don't have any data centers now, so they can come and work with us and compare what they can do.
In the Central Asia, we don't have like in Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan. So if you're gonna like in a way, if you're gonna come up with new idea, it would be like, fantastic, and we can like benefit a lot from this.
It is like a future.
Plans.
In 10, 20 years, we're gonna all have it.
We hope.
Like mobile phones.
Yeah.
If we try our best together, and I think we can do.
For example, yesterday, Mark Zuckerberg met with the president of France, Macron, to discuss about AI labs. So this is the idea that what we can make in Tajikistan. For example, we can have sponsors like Google and Facebook and make it and open the AI labs in Tajikistan. So this is very good idea for Tajikistan to to impact it.
I think we need to write report to Google to build it.
Yeah.
Sure.